Yeah, so today's class, just I would like to discuss on control structures. First, let us understand what is meaning of the control structure. Then we'll discuss what are the different control structures available inside the C programming language. Okay. So before I start, control structure name itself indicating. Let me write here. Control structure. Generally, the meaning of control. When do we use in our general scenario of day-to-day applications? What do you mean by a control? In general, tell me, when do we use a control is a word generally? Go on. Something which is, you know, you do not want to happen and you try to control it. Yes or no? Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
See, until unless you respond, I cannot move forward. You try to respond, whatever I'm asking, okay? Whether it could be yes or no. So the meaning of a control structure is, whenever you do not want something to happen in a particular way, and then you say, I wanted to control it so that it can take the some other behavior or something like that. Yes or no? Correct or not?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Nowadays, the COVID situation is very, we are facing a lot of difficulty. Generally, what doctors will do, based on the condition of the patient, they will choose a different medicines. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, control is all about, you are trying to take a particular decision based on the behavior of something so that it can change its behavior. Am I right? So coming to the programming part, if already we have discussed about the algorithm means what? Algorithm definition, can anybody tell? What is the definition of an algorithm?
It is the process of something to get a result.
Yeah, it is a step-by-step process to get solution for a given problem. Yes or no? Am I right or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When it's a step-by-step process, there are two things, sequential process, non-sequential process. You must understand these two words, very important. Sequential and other one is non-sequential. So what do you mean by sequential? I'm writing a program, maybe statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, maybe statement n. Total, there are n statements are there. Once my computer is going to process all this set of statements in series, sequential means after 1 it should be 2, then it should be 3, then it should be 4. Like that, last one will be the n number of statements. Then I am going to get a solution. Yes or no? Generally. So far we did this only, in yesterday's previous class also. Just we wanted to verify the operators of different categories. Are we not executing the statements step by step? First we performed addition, then we printed the result of addition, then we performed subtraction, then we printed the result of a subtraction. Is it not? Respond.
Yes,
yeah. Yes, when I say non-sequential, even though we write programming like S1, S2, S3, like up to some n number of statements, but generally the procedure is, this is what execution, the procedure, execution of the statements. But in this case, I want to skip maybe S3, S4. S1 will be executed, S2 will be executed. Directly, I will jump to the S5. So this indicates maybe S5 to SN again sequence. So this is an execution. So can I consider it as a non-sequential execution?
Yes, sir.
Tell me. So when you write a program in sequence, but based on my requirement, I wanted to skip the statement 3 and 4. After the statement 2 is executed, I want to jump to the S5 directly. So we are trying to break the flow of sequence. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this kind of requirement is also expected in most of the algorithms. So whenever there's a breakage in the sequential flow of the execution, it's called non-sequential execution. So non-sequential execution is possible only with the facility of a control structures. That you must understand. And I'll give an example. when you want to come to a college by vehicle or some modes, suppose there is suddenly a traffic jam, what do? You will go back to your home or you will take alternative routes?
Alternative routes,
no? So generally when there is no traffic, you will follow S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, SN. There is a traffic jam, you want to skip S3 and S4, yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, similar kind of the requirement is also needed sometimes in the programming part. So to get that kind of behavior, we go with a control structures. So the control structures are again divided into basic two groups. Anyhow, sequential, non-sequential is like, sequential does not need any control structure, but non-sequential needed a control structure, okay? It needs control structures. It needs control structure features. Control structures, features of any programming language, need not to be only this one, of any programming language. Not only C. Whereas doesn't need, okay, it does not need any control structure. It does not need any control structures. Okay, so let me go with, I need a control structure. I want to make my program to behave like a non-sequential execution. So there are two kinds of groupings are done. One is called non-iterative structures. Non-iterative structures. Second one is iterative structures. Or non-iterative statements or iterative statements. Anything is okay. Non-iterative statements. Then iterative statements. First, we'll understand what do you mean by iteration. What do you mean by iteration?
Repetition.
Repetition, right or not? So some set of statement you wanted to repeat again and again. It is something like I'm writing a program S1, S2, S3, S4, maybe some S5. Five statements I'm writing. I want to execute first S1, then S2, then S3, S4 must be repeated maybe 5 times. Are you able to follow what I'm trying to tell? S1 is executed once, S2 is executed once, 3, 4, they will be in sequence. After the 4, I should not come back to the 5. I should go back to the 3 and execute 3 and 4 again. So like that, how many times I want to perform? 5 times. So can I group these two statements are belongs to iterative statements? Can I write this way or not?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Yes, sir.
That is my requirement, okay? The second category is, again, I'm writing a program statement 1, statement 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, there are 7 statements are available. First S1 will be executed, then S2 will be executed. I want to skip S3 and S4. Then I want to execute only S5. Suddenly jump to S7. So anyhow, I'm trying to execute this S5 again and again or only one time? You tell me. Am I executing S5 more than once or only one time?
Once.
Only one time, no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is non-iterative statement. When you are executing any statement in the control structure only once, we call it as a non-iterative statement. When you are executing the set of statements which are repeated, we consider them as iterative statements. So let us understand what are the different syntax. Syntax means the how we use in the C programming part, okay? So let me start with first heading is iterative, non-iterative control structures. Non-iterative control structures. So immediately you should remember that, okay, this control structures is useful to skip some statements and only execute remaining statements only once. That's the meaning of it. So these are the given this way. First one is called if statement, small letter only you can use. The second is called if else statement, there's a space. Then third is called if else if. Then fourth one is called nested if. Okay, So there are four different, and one more is called switch case. So these five different, you know, statements or structures will help us to make our program non-sequential. So let us understand one by one. So when we wanted to use each and every one of this control structure which are non-iterative, let us understand the syntax. The meaning of syntax is how to use them in the programming language without any problem. So something like printf, can I use first variable then followed by a format specifier? So far we have written some programs, no? First a format specifier followed by a variable I'm using, or variable followed by format specifier we are using? Tell me.
Format specifier followed by variable.
So there is a rule, right? We should not deviate from those rules. So that is called the syntax. In the C programming, we should know the syntax of each and everything. So again, I'm not writing every program. So simply the syntax I'm writing for the first one. So I just write it as small if, don't, no, it is not capital letter, if control statement, other way, or control structures, anything is okay. If control statement, the syntax is, if you can write variable here, you can write expression, you can write condition, then every control statement should be associated with a block. We call it as a block. Block will be represented by opening and curly brackets. We can write some statements here. Statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, some random name writing. This is called the body of the statements or statements of the if structure. Statements of if control structure. The syntax actually, it means how we use it, how we use it. Okay, so let me give you an example. I wanted to have the given input, right? You're asking a user you wanted to print only even numbers, or given input is even or not, you want to verify. Okay, that is a simple the question, right? I'm giving an example. User types an integer, and my program should say that my program should decide or print, should print only if it is even. Everybody understood the question? User types an integer, the program should print only if it is even. Is it clear? Is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so generally hash include stdio.h will be there. Then maybe int main or void main, anything is okay. Then maybe int a, where I will take the printf. Printf, enter an integer, maybe with a backslash n. Then what, how can I read the value into the variable? Can anybody tell the statement? What I'm supposed to write here?
Scanf.
Scanf? Yeah, you read out completely after that.
Percent D.
Within double quotes, percentile D.
Ampersand A.
Then what I'll do, if condition, I'm using a condition. Condition means I'm trying to compare A percentile to, it is an expression or not?
Yes, sir.
A percentile to, what is the result?
Zero.
Sorry, reminder, no? Just a minute, I'm getting a call, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, fine. So here there are two things. Whenever you write a percentile 2, the user might give input anything, right? It could be 5. If I'm giving input, typing from the keyboard is 5. 5 percentile 2 is how much?
1.
5 percentile 2, what is the result?
1.
I'm comparing that 1 with 0. Is it true or false?
False
means it will not enter into the if control structure. If it is true, then only it will enter into the control structure. Yes or no? So simply I'll write printf the given input percentile d is even. Can I write this way? Else not required, simply get ch, end the program. Now if user is going to type, there is a, no, after this, what is going to happen? Memory is created with the name of A, the 4 bytes. And after this scanf is done, the keyboard, I'm typing a 5. Then after this A percentile 2 is performed, this whole block, whatever the place, right? This place will be replaced by how much? 1, yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
So 1 double equal to 0, true or false?
False.
So it won't enter into the if control structure. Simply come out, get CH, and nothing will be printed in the output because I have entered 5. Because what is my requirement? User types an integer where program should print only if it is even. 5 is even or odd?
Odd.
So let us execute again. Once again, we'll execute it. Again, int A. 4 bytes with name A will be created, enter the integer, user will type 4 now. Okay, 4 percentile 2 is how much?
0, sir.
0. 0 double equal to 0?
True, sir.
True.
It is true. True means I will enter inside the if control structure. So means statements related to the control structure must be executed. So what is there inside the control structure? Printf, given input percentile d is given, even, what is a value here?
4.
So 4 is even, like that it will print. So does it solve my problem or not? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
And as I mentioned, maybe this is statement 1, this is statement 2, this is statement 3, this is statement 4. So based on the condition, statement 3 might be skipped or it might be part of the program. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So okay. if A input is 5, S3 will be skipped. Yes or not? If A is equal to 4, S3 will get executed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is what I'm trying to explain in the beginning. So let me again go back to my control structure. I'm writing here. I'm just keep on writing a capital. So it is not capital, it should be small. If there's a condition, I'll write statement 1, statement 2 before the if control structure. Inside the control, statement 3, statement 4, semicolon is required. Then statement 5. Then maybe the end of the program. So always prepare a table this way so that you can understand the condition. Somewhere is true or it could be false. Statements executed. Statements executed. Can you tell me if condition is true, what are the sequence of statements get executed? Tell me.
Statement 3 and 4.
If condition is true for the left hand side syntax, what are the statements will get executed in the sequence right from the beginning to the end? Respond.
All statements, sir.
All means you say, tell me the numbers.
Statement 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
If it is false, 1 to 5. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
And one more note. You try to remember this note, most important. If number of statements of a control structure it is valid for all the control structures, if number of statements of a control structure is only one, then the curly brackets, opening and closing curly brackets, are optional. Or optional, optional means you keep it or you don't keep it, does not make any difference. Whereas if number of statements are more than one, the block or opening and curly brackets are compulsory or mandatory. Is it okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So in the previous program, can I is it required to keep opening and curly brackets in this program?
No need, sir.
No need, right? Optional. No need means it is an optional. Even though I keep, it will work. You don't keep also, it will, because inside the control statement I have only one statement, which is printf statement. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now again, I said there are three possibilities inside the condition. So if a percentile 2 double equal to 0, it is a condition. Yes or no? And there is no semicolon, that you must remember. Under the note, again, I will tell. After the if statement, or at the end of the statement, no semicolon must be used. Okay, there should not be semicolon. If you keep a semicolon, the compiler will not throw any error, but your control structure, irrespective of the condition, they always get executed. Are you able to follow?
Yes, sir.
If you keep a semicolon here, the statements related to this block always gets executed, irrespective of the condition, which is of no use. That is the reason better you avoid, or you should not use the semicolon at the end of the control structure. That is more important. So this is one case. Second case, can I use int a, comma c, where a will be read? Okay, I'm using a scan, printf here. I'm using a scanf. I'm not writing completely. C is equal to a percentile 2. If c, can I use this way? This is variable. So a percentile 2, suppose I am entering 5 in the memory. So 5 percentile 2 is how much?
1.
This is a, this is 4 bytes. This is c, again 4 bytes. After the statement is executed, c equal to 1. If 1 means for the computer true or false?
True
means, should I print, I use printf or not? You tell me. Should I use printf or not here?
For checking even or odd, sir.
Yeah, whenever it is true, it indicates it is a not even, right or not?
Yes, sir.
I can write printf, given input is, what should I write? Percentile d is, can I write this way?
Yes, sir.
Can I write it or not? Respond.
Yes,
so this is case 1. This is case 2, where I said it could be a condition within the brackets, it could be a variable within the bracket, and third case, for use if a percentile 2. What should I write here? Odd or even? It is an expression, no? I'm not comparing, simply writing a percentile 2. What do you mean by it? It will replace it by? A percentile 2 will replace it by what? Remainder, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, if remainder is equal to non-zero, what should I, is it true or false?
True.
True, true means what should I print, even or odd?
Odd, sir.
Yeah, printf. The given input is odd, correct or not? Okay, I'm not just writing here. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
See, I'm not getting a confidence from your side. You are confidently telling is it okay or not.
Yes, sir.
You understood or you have any doubts? Tell me. Respond. I'm asking all of you. Is it clear to all of you? Respond.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, if you respond, then I can go to the next topic, which is second one, if-else structure. If-else statement, I should say. So, if-else statement, the second one is the syntax. It is something like, if the condition, same expression, or variable, anything is okay, then you have statements. When I say statements, more than one, okay? Then you write else, then one more block. So there is no semicolon after if statement and after else word. After these two, there should not be any, you know, statements. So this is the syntax. So I'm just giving an example here. Statement 1, statement 2, statement 3. Under the if, I'm writing a condition here. After that, statement 4, statement 5, then statement 6, then else, then statement 7, statement 8, then statement 9. Now, same rule. I have a table here. This is the condition. This is the statements executed. This is more important. Statements executed. If condition is true, if condition is false. Now, you tell me what are the statements are getting executed. If it is true.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
9. 9. Okay. Else part will get skipped. So in the previous case, either include or exclude the set of statements. In the if else structure, definitely some part of the statements are going to be skipped. Yes or no? Either if condition or if related statement will be get skipped or else related statement will be skipped. Okay. When it is false, can you tell me the sequence of statements executed?
1, 2, 3. 7, 8. 9.
9. So 9 will always get executed because they are outside of the statement if and else. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
1, 2, 3 and 9 are always gets executed irrespective of the condition because they are not part of the if and else structures or if and else statements. Either 4, 5, 6 will get skipped or 7 and 8 will be skipped based on the condition. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, can I modify my previous program in a better way? How can I modify? You need to print. My question is slightly changed. Write a program. write a program to print the given input is even or odd. What is the difference between the previous statement and this statement? Tell me.
If it is even, it will print.
Yeah, in the previous programming, only if it is even, you should print. Otherwise, do not do anything. But whereas in this program, whether it is even also you print or odd also, you should print. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So then program will be very simple. Hash include stdio.h, then int main. Then I use int a, then printf, enter any integer. For the verification of even and odd, that you can write if you want. Then scanf, percentile d, ampersand of a, if a percentile 2, I'm using only expression, else. Now you tell me, what should I write here? Printf, given input is, you tell me.
Odd.
Odd or even?
Odd.
So I'm not printing the value, simply only the statement. Given input is?
Even.
What?
Even, sir.
Even.
Even. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Again, getCH will be there at the end. GetCH, then close the bracket. Or return 0, because I'm using an int there. So this is a program of using if-else control structure. Whenever you wanted to have two alternatives, if the condition is true, I wanted to perform the related statements. If it is false, other statements which are related to it. Okay? Any doubts in this second one?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, let me go to the third one. If, else if. Okay, this is an else if statement. So here the syntax is, if you have a more than one condition to check, this is a condition one. You have a statement one, statement two, else if there's no space, even though you give a space, it will work. Anything is okay. Condition two, then statement three and statement four. Then in the else if, last one should be the else. This should not be else if. Maybe statement 6, 5 and 6. Okay, I'll write here statement 0. And maybe at the end I will write statement 7. Now here I have two conditions. When you have two conditions, I'll write condition 1, condition 2. How many possibilities I will get when there are two conditions? How many possibilities? True and true, true and false, false and true, false and false. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you tell me the statements. Get executed. Statements. Get executed. Tell me. When true and true.
1, 2, 3, 4, 7, sir.
0, 1. Tell me.
2, 3, 4, 7.
So directly to jump to 7. In the if else if condition, if first condition is true, remaining conditions will be ignored. Try to remember this. In the if else if statement, generally this kind of programming we never write. Okay, condition 1, if it is true, remaining condition will not be checked at all. It will check for first condition which is true, and that corresponding block is getting executed will come out of the if else if. okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So you must be very careful. Don't think multiple conditions are true, so all will get executed. It is not possible. When you have a multiple conditions, you should write program such a way that only one condition related statements only needs to be executed, otherwise it should not be. Okay, so it indicates that true and false. Can you tell me what is the condition now? True and false, what are the statement get executed?
0 1 2 0 1 2 0 1 2 5 6 7 6 7.
Only 7. Why 5 6 again? Because already true means what? Condition true means 1 2 is got executed. No, when 1 2 get executed, there is no question of executing 3 4 and 5 6. Try to remember.
Okay,
is it clear?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
So whether it is true or a false does not make any sense. So you can simply write it is a don't care condition. When condition one is true, condition 2 can be written as don't care, which is a cross symbol. Okay, is it clear?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, fine. Next, if condition 1 equal to false, then it will check next condition is condition 2. What is condition 2 is true.
True
means, can you tell me the statement which are get executed?
0 3 4 7.
Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Yeah, next, false and false. This is also false, this is false. Then
0 5 6 7.
Do you know?
5 6 7.
Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
So after all the condition is checked, else part is compulsory. It is mandatory. Even though in the structure it is not given, if else if, but last condition must be else condition. If you do not write this, it will give an error. Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, I'll give an example. Only one example I'm explaining because time is very short or less. Remaining you practice from the any book. So I'm just trying to give an example. Find bigger number among the three given inputs. Among the three given integers. Can anybody tell the program? Hash include is blindly you can write stdio.h, then int main, because you are writing in dev C++. How many variables I need to declare?
3.
Int a comma b comma c, yes or no?
Yes sir.
So I am going to create 3 variables. Memory of how many bytes? 4 bytes.
4 bytes.
4 bytes, and name is A, name is B, name is C. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
The next is what? Printf. Enter.
Enter the bigger.
Any 3 anything. Integers. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Then you tell me this, what is scanf? I'm sure supposed to write here.
Percent B.
Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, then if A is greater than B, I want to compare two conditions. So which operator I'm supposed to use?
And
operator, yes or no? So this is one expression, and A greater than C. Printf. Opening and closing brackets are compulsory or not?
Yes sir.
Not required sir.
Or percentile D is bigger. Correct or not?
Yes sir.
Then else if LCF, can you tell me?
B is greater than A and
C. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Percentile D is bigger. Else? Should I check or simply I can write else? If both A and B are not bigger, obviously what is bigger?
C.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Well, let me verify now. Should I use a semicolon here?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Not required, right? Make sure that. And because each and every condition has only one statement, opening and closing brackets, can I keep or not?
Not required, sir.
Not required, but even if I keep it, there's anything problem?
No.
No, sir.
And one statement you can keep, remaining statement you don't keep, also not a problem, okay?
Yes, sir.
But more than one statement you must, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us understand here. When it is going to be, you know, executed, compiler will look at the declaration statement. There are three variables A and B, C. So it will allocate three memory locations of 4 bytes each with a name A, B and C with a garbage, because nothing is defined here. Then printf enter any three integers, it will be displayed on the monitor. Then user will type three inputs. Maybe I'm typing 7, 9, 3. Okay, randomly I'm typing. So 7, 9, 3 will be saved into the memory locations A, B, C. Then I'll come back here. What is going to happen? A greater than B. What is A? 7 greater than 9. True or false?
False.
7 greater than 9, false. True or false?
False.
False. When it is false, do you think I need to check this?
No, sir.
No, sir.
But I'll tell you what it says. The condition will become true only when both are?
True.
True. At least one is false, the computer will default, will not check the second condition. Whenever there's an AND operator, you try to remember this.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We'll skip comparing the second statement. Skip the comparison. When it is 7 greater than 9 is false, it will skip the comparison of the second one. Then we'll directly jump to the else if here. What is B? 9 greater than 3. True or false?
True.
True. Then it will come here. It will check the second one. 9 greater than 7. True or false?
True.
True.
True. True. So percentile D is bigger. What is B here? Output will be 9 is bigger. This is what it is going to print. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Then do you think it will check this?
No, sir.
Else part will get executed?
No.
No. Only one condition is going to be evaluated. So 9 is bigger. So what you can do is you try to modify. First 9 I will type. Then 7 I will type. Maybe some 11 I will type. Then what is going to happen? 9, 7, 11. First here.
First one get executed.
9 greater than 7. True or false?
True.
True.
So then A greater than C. 9 greater than 11.
False.
False. So it will come to second condition. Here. 7 greater than 11.
False.
So do you think it will be executing B greater than A?
No.
Skip. And directly it will print
else.
Execute directly. Execute else part.
Yes, sir.
So what is there? The else part. C. Percentile D is bigger. C. C means 11. 11 is bigger. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I hope, right? Three structures are simple to you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let me go to the fourth one. Nested if. So syntax is statement 1, statement 2, if the condition 1, again you have a more than one condition, then statement 3, statement 4, then I use if within the if, that's called nested if. Condition 2, to try to see why how I am writing. I'm just writing every line after some spaces. That is more important. Then come back. I'm using else. I'm continuing here so that you should not find two different slides. Statement 7. Statement 8. If condition 3. Statement 9. Statement 10. Statement 11. Statement 12. Then get CH. The end. Return 0. Okay, this closing bracket. Assuming that. Maybe this is in the main. Okay. Now again, I will have total how many conditions are there? How many conditions?
Three, sir.
Three conditions. Condition 1, condition 2, condition 3. So how many combinations you will get?
Eight combinations, no?
So maybe false, 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 true, false, true, false, false, true, 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 false, false, true, false, true, 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 false, and true, true, true. 8 are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now you tell me. All 3 are false. Condition 1 is false. Condition 2 is false. Condition 3 is false. Can you tell me the statements now?
1, 2.
Just a minute. Statements executed. I want you to carefully observe what is happening. So, statement 1 will get executed or not?
Yes, sir.
2?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When condition 1 is false, where it will go?
Second.
When condition is false, if is false, which one will it execute? Else part, no?
Yes, sir. Else.
So under the else part, what is there?
7, 8.
7, 8.
7 get executed. 8 get executed. Then condition 3 is?
False.
False. False means? 9, 10 will not get executed. Then directly it will come out of the else condition. Then what is outside the else?
11 and 12.
I hope you understood now here how it is happening. I'm using if condition within the if statement as well as if condition within the else statement. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So once if condition 1 is false, it will jump to the else part. Under the else part, statement 7 and 8 will not be part of the condition 3, so it will be outside the condition 3. It will get executed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now you tell me the second one.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Very good. Then third one.
1, 2.
Condition 1 is false. When it is false, do you think it will enter here? Yeah, 1, 2 I will write. 1, 2 then?
7, 8. 7, 8. 11, 12.
Very good. When condition 1 is false, condition 2 is insignificant. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
When it is false, this is immaterial. This is a don't care condition. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
In fact, from not only here, here to here. If condition 1 is false for the first 4 cases, the condition 2 will not be checked at all. It is of useless things. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So generally, you should not write that way. You never write a program such a way that when condition is false and condition 2 is true, there is no meaning in that. Right or not?
Yes, sir.
You should never write a program such a way that condition 1 is one is false and condition 2 is giving a true, which is of no use. It will never get executed. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So now let me go to the fourth combination. When condition one is false, condition two is immaterial, then 1, 2,
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
So you see, there is no difference between false, false, true, and false, true, true, right or not? It means, as I said, only this false true is important. The middle one is immaterial. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Even here also 1, 2, 7, 8, 11, 12 also same. False, 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 false. Almost same, no? This condition two has meaningless. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now you come back here. When condition one is true, then condition two gets a significance. Yeah, now you tell me.
1, 2, 3, 4, 11, 12.
Tell me.
11, 12.
Because when first condition is true, else will not get executed. So directly I'll go with 11 and 12. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So condition 3 becomes insignificant. When this is true, this becomes insignificant. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, next. True, false, true.
Same, sir. 1, 2, 3, 4, 11, 12.
1, 2.
Same, sir.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 1, 2,
3, 4, 11, 12.
11, 12. Same?
Yes, sir.
Then this one.
1, 2.
1, 2.
3, 4.
3, 4.
3, 4. 5, 6.
5, 6.
11, 12.
11, 12. Correct? Then final one.
R should be executed.
1, 2. 3, 4. 5, 6. 11, 12. Same, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I hope you understood nested if now.
Yes, sir.
There is no restriction on how many if condition you can go in within a if condition, okay?
It is correct.
I can have if within a if, like take any number of times. There is nothing wrong, but only thing is confusion arises more the number of nested if. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the last one, switch case. The fifth one. Switch case. So there are two different words. The syntax will be switch. Only integer variable. Okay, integer variable. Or expression which leads to integer results. Expression which gives integer results. Which gives integer result. Anything you can use. No float, okay? That you must remember. Then there is a block associated with this. Inside that there is a case followed by you can use maybe some integers here. Integers are character. Character is also acceptable. Integer variable and character variable. For the character variable, you should write single quotes or else simple number. I think there is small change here. It is not colon, semicolon, it is a colon. Then you write statements 1, statement 2, statement 3. Then, just a minute. Then there is a statement called break. You should write it here. I'll explain what is the meaning of a break. Then case 2. There is a space between the case and the word or the integer. Then statement 3. Sorry, not 3. 4. Statement 5. You can have any number of cases, but I'm just writing only two cases. Then the last one is called default. Default. Statement 6. Statement 7. Then switch is closed. Maybe statement 9, get CH. Then end, return 0, end. Okay, here the thing is very simple. When you write a switch followed by within the parenthesis, you can write only integer variable or a character variable, or it could be an expression which gives an integer result. Not other than these three conditions, float is not acceptable. So suppose whatever, if I'm using integer, I'm assuming I'm using an integer variable here. If integer variable value is equal to 1, it will directly jump to the case 1, because followed by the case, whatever number you are writing, that number must match with the result of this integer variable. So if integer variable is 1, statement 1, 2, 3 will get executed break. Break means it will come out of the switch case, switch case. And I'm not writing break in the case 2. Let us see what is going to happen. If my integer variable result is 2, okay, assuming that. So case 1 will be skipped, directly it will jump to the case 2. 4, 5 will get executed. Because I'm not writing a break, followed by whatever cases you are getting, maybe it's a default or some other case, the sequential, you know, statement, whatever available, they will also get executed. That is a problem. So assuming that if the integer result is 1, then, okay, I'll write this way. The integer value is 1. Then statements get executed. Can you tell me? Okay, I'll write outside statement 0, anyhow to indicate. Yeah, tell me 0,
1, 2, 3.
Then outside, what is the statement?
9.
9.
Suppose variable value is 2. If integer variable value is 2, what is going to happen?
0, 4, 5, 6,
0.
4, 5, 6, 7.
4, 5, 6, 7.
6, 7, 9.
Achha, 8 I have not written, let it be 9. Okay. Then if it is 3,
0, 6, 7, 9.
0 will be there.
6, 7, 9.
Because if it is 3, it doesn't match with the 1, doesn't match with the 2. Direct it will jump to the default. Other than 1 and 2, any number the integer variable is going to have, directly it will jump to the default. So after the 0, which one it will get executed? 6, 7, 9. Correct or not? Is it clear?
Sir, can you explain the switch thing again, sir?
Okay, I will explain once again. In the switch syntax, what is going to happen is, the syntax says, after the switch, which in the bracket, you should write only 3 possibilities. Either you can use a character variable, or you can use an integer variable, or you can use an expression which must give you an integer result, okay? So right now I'm using an integer variable, and whatever variable they has a value, that value must be present after the case word. Actually, case word I'm using here, case space followed by the word, whatever you write, it must match with the result. Need not to be 1, 2, 3 onwards. You can write 7, 8 also. There's nothing wrong, provided the variable should have a value 7 and 8. Okay. So I'm writing, if the variable is equal to 1 here, integer variable value is 1. So, because this 1 will match with this 1, which is written after the case, direct it will jump to this particular section. So, the colon indicates the start of the section, break indicates the end of a section. So, after the colon, whatever statements are there, they get executed. Because integer value is 1, it will jump to this case 1, which is written here. Statement 1, 2, 3 get executed. Because 0 is written outside this switch, it gets executed all the time. Then, because integer variable is 1 here, the section 1 is going to be executed with statement 1, statement 2, statement 3. Because I'm using a break, break is a line which indicates you should come out of the switch control structure. When you come out means after this closing bracket. After this closing bracket, what is available? 9 is there. So that is the reason 0, 1, 2, 3, 9 gets executed. By chance, if my integer variable is 2, suppose. 2 means it will directly jump to the section where 2 is written here after the case. So it will skip the case 1, directly will jump to the statement 4 and 5. After the 0, 4 and 5 get executed. Because I'm not writing the break, it will sequentially execute remaining also without going anywhere. So immediately I'm finding 6 and 7. So 6 and 7 will get executed. I have reached to the end of the switch statement, it will directly come out and 9 will be get executed. This is the second possibility. Then third possibility is, I'm writing some numbers after the cases, and any number other than these two cases, it need not to be 3, anything other than 1 and 2, default gets executed. If there is no match of the result with the available cases inside the switch, the default case will get executed. So because I'm writing a 3 here, neither 1 is getting matched nor 2 is getting matched. It will jump to this default case. So after the 0, 6 and 7 get executed. Anyhow, there is no break is required because default is the last one. So break is optional. Once the switch case is over, immediately 9 is available. So 0, 6, 7, 9 gets executed. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let me give you an example. You might ask, there must be a difference between if else if condition or this one, because only one is there, no? Only one condition is going to be executed, no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I'll give you a simple, the difference between check the condition sequentially. Check the condition sequentially. Select the required option. Select the required option. Both are same or different? Check the condition sequentially, select the required option. Both are same or different?
Different.
Different.
Different in what way? Here, each condition is checked till you reach to a required condition is matched or not. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Each condition is checked. Each condition is checked till you get required condition, right? Till you reach to a required condition. Required condition. Whereas here you jump to the required case directly. Which one is faster?
Second one, sir.
So this is switch case. Whenever in your program selection kind of options are available, go for
switch case.
Whenever you want condition sequentially, you wanted to verify, then go for you understood. So generally, you know, nowadays there are so many websites are there. By looking at which hospital has how many beds facility and how much oxygen levels availability. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Government has made some website where you can verify which hospital has the freely available beds and freely available oxygen. Yes or no? Oxygen. Tell me. You know that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, suppose that website is not available and somebody, a patient, need an oxygen, what do you do? You will search each and nearby hospitals, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You go to hospital one, you will verify whether the availability of a bed or oxygen. If it is not available, what do? You'll go to the next hospital. Then there also they will not find any, freely available bed or oxygen. Then you'll go to third hospital. Like that, you keep on moving from one to the other hospital, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Correct?
Yes, sir.
Respond.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Whereas in the if website facility is available, so and so hospital 10, right? Hospital number 10 has maybe some number of beds and oxygen levels. Then don't you go directly to that hospital only? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Which one is better? Selection is better or condition checking is better?
Selection is better.
Okay, so it all depends on application. Every application may not need a selection. Some applications demand condition checking. Generally, quality testing of products, right? In every manufacturing industry, every product needs to be tested. Okay, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So there, if condition is required or switch case is required.
If condition, sir.
Yeah. So it means where every product needs to be checked, yes or no? And selection is, it all depends on application. You cannot simply say that. And I'm telling, every switch case program can be replaced by if condition. Agreed or not?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, every if condition cannot be replaced by
switch case.
You agree that?
Yes, sir.
Every note, every if condition or if else if program can be written by using switch case. Yes or no? No, there is something wrong, right? Every if else condition program cannot be written by using switch, right? Cannot be written by using switch, whereas every switch case can be replaced by if else if. Yes or no? Try to remember this. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
I'll give you an example. When I think most of you play the video games or in your mobiles. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
I think most of you, right? So in the games, you have a multiple levels, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, like that. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So some games, until level 0 you complete, level 1 cannot be possible. Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Whereas some games, based on your interest or your expertise, you can directly jump to that level program. You can directly play level 3 relevant game. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, what you can understand is, there are programs which are written by using if condition where until unless the level 0 is completed, level 1 cannot be given. Until level 1 is completed, level 2 cannot be given. This is a condition based. And based on the expertise, the programmer or the user can directly enter into the any level. It's called switch case. Agree? Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay, sir.
Last example. With the example, I'll wind up today's class. Generally, the switch case will be used to display some kind of menu options. Okay. So here, what is that? This I just wanted to perform a calculator of arithmetic operation, something like calculator. Calculator for only arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators. How can I write this? Hash include stdio.h, then main. Then, because I'm performing arithmetic operator, I need at least 3 variables. Then printf, enter 2 integers. I think one more variable is required. Choice. The variable name is a choice. Enter. Not the iPhone, actually. There's a slight change. Okay, I'm just writing. Okay. So printf, one means addition / n, two means subtraction / n, three means division / n, four means reminder. Okay, reminder / n. Then I'll ask a user, printf, enter your choice. Enter your choice. Then I use a scanf. What should I use? Percentile D. Ampersand of what? What should I write here? Tell me. When I say enter your choice, which variable I should read out of the ABC choice? Respond. All the students.
Sir.
Which variable, ABC or choice?
Choice.
Okay. Then maybe switch here. I'm writing choice here. Then I'm using a space, case, one colon. Before that, there are two things. You can write printf, enter two inputs for addition. Then scanf. What should I use?
Percentage D into.
Percentage D, how many times?
Two times, sir.
Two times. And after that, ampersand?
A.
Comma, ampersand? B. Then C is equal to what choice one indicates?
Addition.
A plus B, yes or no? Printf. The addition is. Addition is percentile D. Should I use a break or not?
Yes. Sir. Break.
Yes, sir.
Then phase two. Again, printf. If it is a two, two means what? Again, subtraction, no?
Yes, sir.
Even subtraction also, you need inputs or not?
Yes, sir.
Do I need to read inputs again here, or already the read inputs will be valid?
We should read, sir, again.
Yeah, we should read again because every section is different. Enter two inputs for subtraction. Backslash n. Again, scanf.
Percentile D.
Ampersand A.
B.
Comma, ampersand B. C is equal to
A minus B,
printf,
subtraction
result is, or the subtraction is percentile D backslash N C. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Then again, case three. Again, do I need again reading of the inputs, printf, enter two inputs for dividend and divisor, yes or no? Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Then scanf, percentile D, backslash A, comma, ampersand A, comma, ampersand B. Then C is equal to A divided by B, printf. Hey, I should use break now here. Yes, sir. No? You should tell. Okay, printf. The quotient is percentile D backslash N, then C. Then case four. Printf. Enter two inputs, same for divisor and dividend. Dividend and divisor. It is more specific actually. Divisor. Then scanf. Percentile D. Ampersand A, comma, ampersand B. C is equal to A percentile B. Then printf. The remainder is percentile D backslash N C. Break is needed or not? Break is required or not? Tell me.
Not required, sir. In case three break.
Here also required because I need to write default also, no? The syntax, right or not?
Yes, sir.
What should I write default? Printf? What should I write? Can I write this way?
Yes, sir.
I think this is the end of the program. You understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So choice. Now I wanted to avoid printf and scanf of two statements in each case. Can I write before the switch or not? See here, each case you are reading two inputs, no?
Yes, sir.
Tell
yes,
me.
Sir, we can write, sir.
Where you are specifically mentioning two inputs for the addition, two inputs for the subtraction, two inputs for the divisor and dividend. Instead, can I write only once? Can I write it or not?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So that is a homework for you. Read inputs only once before the switch. Where to use that you only decide, and then you perform the required operation. Okay.
Below scanf, sir.
Sorry.
Below scanf.
Yeah, wherever it is, you try to verify. Then I want. You also verify removing the break and including the break, so you can understand the difference of the, you know, writing the importance of the break. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So with this, all the control structures, you know, of five types, which are iterative or non-iterative. All these control structures, whatever we discuss, belongs to iterative or non-iterative.
Non-iterative,
right? So next class we'll discuss about the iterative control structures, and then we'll spend one class only for the program execution part. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So with this, I'll stop for today's class. Let me stop sharing the screen. Now let me stop recording also.